So it's a pretty straightforward race as we take a look at the record that Laura Muir set last year, the outdoor best. That's on the track as Faith Kipyegon set a new world record. Not expecting those marks to be tested today. And really, these first few steps, Kara, are going to be critical. We've seen some slick conditions from some of the other racers earlier in the day.
Yeah, we've seen some people slip right here off this first step off here. So this, everyone's going to be a little timid off the line here, I would think, until they finally get their feet underneath them and settle in. But they'll be a little delicate here at the beginning.
New York makes it very easy for course measurement. They start at East 80th. They'll run to East 60th. 20 blocks to crown a champion in the 5th Avenue mile. Sounds like there may still be a little bit of reflection here at the line. Talking to some of the athletes, you know, making sure that their footing, last thing you want to do is tweak something going into the off season where the marks are for the crosswalk for like that bus where there's paint on it. They say that's the slickest part of the course.
Yeah, they need to be careful here. And Paul, I just want to point out the smiles at the start line. This has a different feel than a world championship or a Diamond League race. The athletes really, there's a good sense of camaraderie and just having fun out here on the roads.
About 4.5 minutes away from the off season for a host of those. Still others hoping to be part of the Diamond League final next week in Eugene. There's also a race within the race because there's a bonus reaching the halfway point first. We'll talk about that here as the race gets underway. Fifth Avenue mile, the racing underway for the elite women as they start at East 80th Street and head down towards the finish line on 60th.
Well, that was a nice clean start. I was worried someone might slip. We saw some of that in some of the earlier races, but everyone got off the line. I felt like they were all a little timid, but once now they found their footing, and now we're starting to see them get comfortable on that road, get comfortable with the slickness underneath their feet, and the racing begins.
Number of the athletes on this list that we just showed you haven't run a road mile, haven't run here in New York, and because this is just point to point, we've talked to the athletes over the years, one of the biggest things they got to gear up for is the finish line comes into view pretty early in this race, but it's not as close as you think.
Yeah, we were at the technical meeting last night, Paul, and the meet director was reminding them, hey, it's not as close as you think. There's still a long way to run. So I do think that this is a race where the more times you come back, the more you really learn this course. But it's not a perfectly flat race, Paul. Typically, the first quarter is downhill, and then they climb up for the second quarter, and then the second half is relatively flat.
As we mentioned, some of these athletes have been in Europe racing post the World Championships, and it's going to be true for both the men and the women that you have somebody who's got legs that have been gassed by European training, a day to regroup, because that Brussels race was just on Friday, and here it is Sunday, and they're trying to win here in New York.
And all those athletes ran really well. Tanaka broke her own Japanese national record in the 5,000 meters. And it's just incredible to see these women hop on a plane and get here and get in this race and fight to finish high here.
It's Tanaka's 28th race of the year. She is near and picture on the far right, on the far right side of your screen now. Kayla Edwards now trying to move ahead, and there is a halfway prize here. $1,000 to the leader at the halfway mark, but they say you have to be honest because you got to finish under 4:32 to win that bonus.
Absolutely. So we see Kayla Edwards, she kind of pushed through that half mile and she immediately let off the gas. So as long as she runs under 4:32 by the finish, she will get that halfway bonus. And we see Hiltz now really coming into our picture, Paul. They're starting to be shown. They were kind of hiding in the back in that first half, but now they're moving up. They love this race.
See Danny Jones in the mix there, back in fourth position, but now a trio up in front. Gemma Riki, who's won this race before, Hall in her very first road mile appearance, and perhaps has to be the one who has the inexperience of what it feels like in the second half of this race, because that view of 60th is now coming into view.
Yeah, this is where experience will really come into play. But remember, Hall races so much. So yes, the surface is different and the course is different, but she knows her body so well. And they do have markings on the course. They'll see the three-quarter mark. They'll see 400 to go. They'll see 200 to go. So she will have an indication. But we see Riki really pushing now.
Ellie St. Pierre's in that mix, though, losing a little bit of traction with the lead group. And now you can see Hall going to the arms. Riki looks very composed and ready to run. And Nikki Hiltz trying to stay in it as well.
Hiltz has got to shuffle up right now. They can't let them get any more space. But Riki looks very relaxed, Paul. You are correct. She looks just like she's floating right now, like she has more in the tank if she needs it.
From this head-on shot, it's hard to see how many are still in the mix for this championship. Into the last quarter mile here, everybody in full stride. Riki, Hiltz, and Healy. And here comes Healy on the inside, challenging Riki. And now Riki back to the lead. Into the final strides, Gemma Riki's coming back to New York and wins another Fifth Avenue mile.
That was a great race out of Gemma Riki. She really planned that well. She didn't get caught up in anything early. She protected her position, and she knew when to move. She's now a two-time winner of this Fifth Avenue mile. Great race for her.
And a quick one, 4:19.
That is very quick. You know, I kind of thought that we'd see slower times today just because of the timidness off that first, the start in that first quarter. But once Riki got going, she was just absolutely rolling.
So we go back and have a different view of this finish here. Healy challenging there. Riki on the inside, but Riki finding more energy when it mattered most.
I think Riki was confident in her clothes. We saw her clothes super well earlier this year in an 800 to win in the Diamond League. I think she knew she had that clothes, and she's also run here before, so she knew when was the time to unleash that finishing kick. And what a brilliant race out of her to win the Fifth Avenue mile.
2 years ago, she ran 4:22 to win her first Fifth Avenue mile title. Had to do it quicker here to win the 42nd edition, and at the finish line, she's with Lewis.
All right, Paul, thanks very much. Well, Gemma, if tough conditions, kind of give us a sense of how you were able to navigate this course and get another win here in New York.
Just like home. It's just like home, but yeah, I just kept my cool and didn't think about the conditions, and I knew if I was up there with less than 800 meters to go, I could turn my legs pretty quick. So yeah, I'm really pleased with that race.
Taking us inside the last half mile of the race, what were you paying attention to in terms of your competitors and really how much more distance you had to cover?
I probably pushed on a bit more than what I would have liked to have done the work, but it just shows how strong I've gotten over the past few years. And yeah, I was just keeping an eye and making sure I didn't lose any of them.
Right. And Gemma, season is not over. You'll be in Eugene for the end of the Diamond League series?
Yeah, I'll be out there, so staying in the States for another week or so.
We're happy to have you here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Paul?
Probably helped her, Kara, that the five-time Irish champion, Sarah Healy, was battling there at the finish line. So Scotland picks up another Fifth Avenue mile win.
Yeah, we've talked about that. They've dominated this event, right, with Jake Whiteman and Gemma Riki, Laura Muir, so good for Riki. She comes back and keeps that Scottish title.